Hi guys, earlier this year I have uploaded a video of this Ertiga that I was about to buy it on. That time I was thinking of buying this Ertiga, and I uploaded the video which was taken to show my dad about the features and about this vehicle. But I thought it should be public though, so I uploaded it publicly because there was no other videos like that from the user side about the vehicle. All the videos I found was from the commercial company, like the advertisement site. That's why I, on a user perspective, I uploaded the video and it got many likes also. So two of the YouTubers commented on that video that they want to see the smart key feature of that vehicle and other details also. And one of the friends also asked me if I am experiencing any engine trouble, any mechanical issue or anything like that. But I have to say that I have been running this vehicle for 10,000 kilometers and it has been 4 months. And I don't experience any engine problem or any mechanical defects in this vehicle until now. And four of my friends also own the same model, is a DI+ HHVS, same model. And one of my friends have ridden it about 60,000 kilometers above, and he also has the same opinion that this vehicle does not have any mechanical or any issues like that, any problem like that. And for me, this vehicle is great. It has got enough power. Many of them say that Ertiga is not got no power, it lacks a lot, it is a very powerless vehicle. But I don't think so. It has a lag until you hit the 2000 rpm point, it lacks a bit. But when the 2000 rpm point is hit, the turbo kicks in and it has a great acceleration, and I have been enjoying it a lotly. No problem at all. And about the mileage, actually the fuel economy, it is giving me about 23 kmpl on the city highway ride, or in the cities it will be giving 19 20 18, like that. But it is a pretty decent mileage if you ask me for a 7-seater like that. It is a mileage of a sedan or any other car like that, which has a lower power than this vehicle. I can bet it also has a good comfortable seats, and the vehicle is a good rideability in the long route. There's no problem. I have gone many places with this vehicle. So coming to the point, this video today we are speaking about the smart key feature of this vehicle. This is the smart key they are giving with the vehicle. Sorry, there is a rubber cover on it. Nothing much to see inside. It is just like this inside. Also, there's a LED indicator. There's a lock key. There's an unlock key, and there's a physical key also in this. I hope you can see that. With one hand, I am unable to pull it out. I think so. I'm sorry. Yeah, that's it. It's a physical key. See, this physical key is used to if the battery of this key is dead or getting low, the vehicle won't be sensing your unlock sequence. Then if you want to enter the vehicle, you just pull out this physical key, and there's a hole in the driver's side. You just unlock the door, and while getting in, press the start switch button with this key, and the vehicle will start up. That's what the showroom in the showroom just told me, because key gets battery low and I am stuck outside somewhere in any place, what should I do? This told me like that. You can start the engine like that. Okay, so coming to the point, in any smart key, like any remote car, there are lock key and unlock key. One beep means lock, two beep means unlocked. And another feature of the smart key, if you have the smart key in your hand or in your pocket or somewhere in your body, there is a red button, black button here, which is used to unlock this vehicle. See, it is unlocked, and you can open the dicky or any door. Every door has this black button, and if you press it again, it locks again. That's it. And I have it, there is also on all door sides, but I covered it with my this chrome plating. That's why you can't see it. It is under the chrome plate. Okay, and coming to inside the vehicle, there is no, you have been noticing that it's a smart key, that it means wireless key, no need of keyless entry. Yeah, okay. If this means you don't have to put any key or key in the whole keyhole oriented. It just don't have a keyhole, it just has a start and stop button. That's it. So you may ask how it starts. Just enter the vehicle and press the start button like this, and the first ignition is on. You can see it was just a minute, and again you press the fuel pump gets charged, and other instruments and everything comes up. If you press it again, sorry, 1 minute. If you press it again, it kills the engine. Sorry, it switches off. So you may ask how to start the engine if it is like that. Two times you press it and it comes on. You have to push down the clutch. When you push down the clutch, see that green light over there? That means press the button to start the engine. If you release the clutch, the light goes off. If you press down the clutch, the light goes off. You press down the clutch and press the start button, it comes online. That's it. It is the key feature. I just have my key with me. That's it. But this key should be inside the vehicle, anywhere in the car. That's it, anywhere. If it is in your pocket, if it is in your back pocket, it is in your shirt pocket, if it is in your bag, that's enough. That's enough for it. If you do, you may ask, then what if the key does not, if you don't have the key? I will show you that also. If I am putting this key over my bonnet, or I have put the key over the bonnet, and when I press the start button, see, it is asking for the key. There is a little sign over there. Key. I hope you guys can see. Forgive me for this low quality video because I don't have any camcorders and my mobile has been falling in the water a week ago, and I have to buy an emergency mobile. That's it. That's why. See, there is a key signal that indicates that there is a key is not inside the vehicle. Okay, if I am taking my key, see, key, and if I just enter the inside or inside of the vehicle, and I'm going to put it over there. Okay, I'm going to put it over there, and if I press the start button, it comes online. No problem at all. That's it. And recently I am having a problem. There is a problem in this smart key feature actually, because I got into a bit of trouble because of this key. I think none of you have experienced this, because when I was with my friend, he was driving the car and he had the smart key. When he reached his home, he just went out and he forgot to give me the smart key, this key to me. And I just, the engine was not killed actually. So I swapped the places with the driver, the driving seat, and just I went to home. The key was actually with my friend, and I just went to home. Afterwards, when I was searching to unlock the key, I cannot find the key. So I called him and he said that he has the key in his pocket. But I cannot, when I switched off, I cannot restart the engine. But I used my spare key for that. They are giving two keys of this. There are two of them in case of I lost one. So I use the second key to lock the car. So if you lose this key while the engine is on, you won't be searching for that. There's a probability of that. You won't be searching for this key, right? the engine is on. If someone like that, someone if you are in a unknown town and going for an outing, you saw a friend and he drives a vehicle, drives your car, and unfortunately he goes for his house and you are returning and he has the key like that. My friend took it. He has the key. If you go anywhere and stop the vehicle, that's it. You are screwed. You are literally screwed. You cannot take it out in anything. After switching off the engine, after 2 minutes, the doors also get locked automatically. Yeah, you can open it manually inside from the vehicle, but it will also trigger the alarm. Yeah, that's a bit of a pain actually. I thought they should give a warning of something like that. If the engine is started and the key is out of the car, there should be any warning. There is not such thing actually. And there are other warnings also. If I put the health light or parking light on and I am trying to switch off, if I off the vehicle completely, I off the vehicle, it beeps that it's saying that your park is on or your light is on or something is on, check it. I think that same should be, it is also for handbrakes also, that if the door is not closed also there is a warning light and warning sound. Actually the warning light is more not appropriate. There should be a warning sound. There's a warning sign actually. The engine knows, or I noticed that the engine knows, or the earlier I showed the key sign, it pops up if the key is not inside the car. But around that much light, we won't be noticing that the key light has been on or something like that. There should be a warning actually. I think so. That should be a. If you want, that's it. I don't want to bragging about this as because forgive me for mistakes, for my language or anything I did, and mainly forgive me the low quality video I have uploaded. I'm very very sorry about this, but I just want to help you guys. That's it, your request. That's it for me. That's it. I don't have any other sources to make a good quality video. That's why I'm doing this. I'm very sorry. And if I did anything wrong in this video demonstration, or in this demonstration, sorry, forgive me. I'm not a professional. This is my first time I'm doing it. That's it. Have a nice day. Thank you guys.